can't even do Forza. What the actual fuck? Okay. What can we do about this? I think we can do all the single player stuff, but yeah, I guess some of this is gonna be unavailable. Okay, well, oh, maybe not. It's trying. Oh, hang on. Why? Oh, nope. It's working. Cool. Okay. Right, now that we can actually properly start on this, rather than fucking about with Xbox being shit. Right, wheel spin. Take a photo of any cult car. Well, that's pretty easy. Where's Citroen? Oh, there's no Citroen. Oh, there's no 2CV in this game. Okay. That's what I was going to do, but I know the SD1 is a cult car, so we'll use that. Easy. Cult car. What? It's not a cult car? Okay, what does Forza class as a cult car then? Cult car. Is there a SD1 not a cult car? What, it's not? Okay, I'm just going that one. There we go. Nice. There's a lot more cars to photo as well. I think these will be previews of stuff from the next season. I see the Series 30 next week, so let's have a look. Not captured. We have the Alfa Romeo 155Q4 and Austin 7. XC4 Bucket, the Cunning Zagesco. That's going to be amazing. Oh, I can't wait to drive that. It's 998 standard. Fuck me. And the Triumph TR7. Nice. So let's take a look at this. We're going to quickly go around. We've got the Napier Railton. We've got the Alumicraft, Ferrari SD12, Hurricane Performante, and the AMG Hammer, which is going to be amazing. So let's start with this first, because I think the online is going to be a bit buggy out. So I'm going to do all the single player stuff. I might drop another stream later to get all the online stuff redone. But I'll tell you what I will use for them, just so if it does come up, you can try for yourself. So I actually don't even know what we're doing. It looks off-road. Okay, looks like I got no car set up for this. Okay. It's after B Retro Saloon off-road. Okay. Let's have a look. So, Retro Saloon. Can I sort by class? There you go. So, we want something around B class. We can four-wheel drive. Sierra Cosworth? got M3 Los Cart and M5. I might go with the RS. Should we go with the RS2 actually? I think the RS2 is probably better. Alright, let's fix this up then. First thing we're going to want, the absolute best thing, is rally compound tyres. Okay, fuck that, that takes it to A class. Really? Fuck, he does that much improvement? I guess we're not then. Okay then. We'll come back to that. Let's see what aero. I think they're definitely going to be better than top speed on an off-road. Can we convert? Do a 1 litre rally in line 4. I think that's probably better. We want all drive. Better clutch plate. We want better brakes. Weight shedding will be important. Camshaft, too much. Block, that's too much. Turbos, that's too much. Restrictor plates, too much. Okay, that's all too much. So we're going to have to go down the route of weight shedding. Drop that. I guess we'll put some new wheels on it, a slightly better weight. They look nice, we'll go with that. Bigger tyres. Wider tyres. Nope, that's axle widths. That's wider tyres. Probably at the back. Maybe not. There's not a great deal we can actually do. 695 might be what we have to stick with. Yeah, fuck it. 695 is the best we can get on this, but it should be good enough. So we've lost 11 horsepower. I think actually we don't engine swap. Because then we can probably get more power out of this engine. Yeah, that's gained 19 horsepower. We'll keep it like that then. We don't want the I4. Cool. Let's get ourselves an AMG Hammer then. Anything here that is not all drive converted are going to absolutely suffer when we hit the off-road segment. Ooh, that's a new car. That is the Alpha 155. Got to keep on top of that photography. I feel like this is a lot bigger and bulkier than most other retro saloons. But it's not exactly sluggish either. Probably on the older end as well. Also, first of all, where is this off-road in this off-road race? It has been literally the tarmac of water. Oh, I didn't need to brake that much on there. Okay, it does understeer a little bit actually. Okay. Got jumped by an M3. No. That's better. Oh, finally, here's the dirt. This is where I'm just going to soar away. That was literally next to no dirt. Right, on to the next. Come on. There we go. And go. Yeah, I think it is slugging a little bit on top end speed. That should all come into play here. Can you not just cut me up? Okay. Just such violent AI. Right, one more lap of this to go. Just soar away from people. I should be uncatchable now. Last dirt segment left. Nice. That is race two done. And we get a spin. I have lost at end. Only 15 grand, god damn it. Right, let's finish this off. With one last sprint. We should just jump a lot of them at the start. Power of all-wheel drive. Immediately onto the dirt, that's brilliant. Just show them the advantage of all-wheel drive. But also show them the disadvantage of being slightly underpowered. Ooh, it seems to be pretty tight in these corners. Jump on dirt. That's better. Now we can just walk away. Car is so good just gliding over bumps and dirt. This is the ideal retro saloon rally racer. Easy. And we swipe out all those money. And get our AMG hammer. Nice. 25k. Another 25k. And we get another wheel swing because we leveled up in dirt, which has been backlogged. Okay. But we now have our AMG hammer. Very nice, powerful saloon. So, let's see what's next on our to-do list. Let's get the Hurricane. What does that want? S1900 Lamborghini. Okay, I feel like I'm going to use the Hurricane to beat the Hurricane. Well, I feel like the Hurricane is a bit too easy. How about I try something that's not a Hurricane Performante? If you don't own a Hurricane Performante, Gallardo is very good. Aventador J is also very good. But I'd use the Gallardo Superleggera. Tell you what, I'll do 1, 2, 3. Yeah, we'll show that off. I'll take the Gallardo Spider first. Where is it? Down here. Likes the Performante, but we'll take this Gallardo Spider to start with. Just to show what you can do if you don't have one. Okay. Fuck me. So basically you jump all those in the accident, jump the mirror. Fucking traffic. It's always on hills. Just blind corners. Jump the Hurricane there. I saw that coming and I even fucking lined up with it. They are so far out ahead. Whatever is winning. I feel like they just escaped the accident and end up just so far ahead that they're just uncatchable. Yeah. God damn it. Well, we'll take second for now. It was an Aventador. I wouldn't recommend the Aventador. I find them too big, too bulky. Actually. So where are we going next? We go up here. And we'll try the Gallardo Superleggera hardtop. So this one is slightly better than the convertible. Let's go. Bit of a slip on there. Fuck's sake. Smallest, just off by the smallest amount. We can take this Hurricane, we can take the Reventon. It's just another Gallardo and that Aventador left. We can take things tighter. Perfect. A lot of sliding around in this. Yeah, so ideally I recommend a Gallardo, or maybe even a Hurricane if you don't have the Performante. But Gallardos do well, and that should put me equal top. Well, top. And then the last one is over here. And we'll do this in the Aventador J. Just in case you don't have a Gallardo. Come on. So it's only 871. So it's not been touched at all. It's completely stock, but oh well. It shouldn't be too difficult. There's already another Aventador J just holding everyone up. See what I mean? These cars are massive to get round people. A lot of Ventadors, a lot of Reventon. Yeah, Yeah, the Purple Manta's got the absolute best lasso of any Lamborghini on offer. You can just throw it round corners so much and it will just go. To be fair, this Aventador J is actually doing pretty well. I think this has a lot better aero than a standard Aventador though. If you have an Aventador, put some aero on it. It should kind of be like this Aventador J. Easy enough. Cool, that should get me another Performante. Got more money. Nice. Easy, and that'll be our 50%. Oh no, Series 29 80% bonus, which is the Wrangler. Yeah, there we go. So, aerodrome, nope, that's that. Let's do the Ferrari F12, which requires a class of GT cars. Ooh. Let's find ourselves some GT cars. The 8C seems pretty good. So does a Bentley. I already have a Bentley set up. I'm going to use the Bentley. This Bentley is very fast. So let's get that done then. A Bentley is the best offer for this. I've used this car many times and it is amazing. Let's go. Oh, okay, a lot of Bentleys in this. I think Alphas will be good. M6, no. Jags, again, probably not the best idea. Quartz Regalia is just, again, just nope. Fucking get off me. The new thing with this car is that it's a lot heavier than everything else. But it is a lot more powerful than everything else. Catch that Regalia. I don't know if it's me, but things feel a lot more understeery. I don't know if it's to do with the new update. I had another configure for PC, so I feel that some of the configs might have been changed. But this should not be struggling like this. Just to make corners. Why is it such understeery? This should not be this difficult. Why can I physically not catch up to these two? Okay, that was just terrible. A Bentley can out-top-end a Maserati Gran Turismo. I did massively miss. Why is it struggling so much? This is so weird. Unless they've actually upped the driver car difficulty of unplayable. What's the other one? Untouchable. Whatever the highest one I'm on. Was it? Unbeatable. Unless they've upped the actual difficulty, because unbeatable in Horizon is nothing like unbeatable in motorsport. Unbeatable in Horizon is about above average in motorsport, maybe highly skilled. Just keep getting fucking stuck in the back of bloody cars. Oh, this is horrible. But this car is just I feel like the steering wheel just does nothing. It's like an aircraft carrier. It never used to be like this. Okay, just cut me up. Why does it lurch so much? I don't know why this feels so heavy. I know this is a heavy car, but this has been modified with massive weight reduction. Okay, let's finish this off then with another circuit race. Why am I not making corners anymore? What have they done? Okay. Quite nice interior. Let's go. Come on, one last flying lap. Just complete understeer. God, this is just horrible. Well, at least we're finished and done with this now then. The Ferrari F12 TDF. Nice. It doesn't seem too bad. I don't know why you're struggling in that race. Oh. Let's hop back onto this. Do the showcase remix. Get that done. So what are we doing with this? We're in the ZR2 and we're racing the hovercraft. Okay. Go for another jump. And we are winning. A bit of a plonk when it landed. okay, just fucked me out. Scheduled to do that, just win at the last minute. Get a wheel spin out of that. Well, I guess we're doing that now. Why, hurrah, hurrah, 300k? Oh! Mercedes 100, that's decent. A Huayra in 300k would have been about 500,000 spin. Let's do these then. The aerodrome, gotta do at least 200. I could probably do that in the Bentley. Could not do that in the Bentley. Oh, we're gonna have to change something that will very easily do that. This thing, that even if I line up, just launch the car. ...50, 60, 70, 80, 200 already. 225 from the Rimac. And speed chat hero level up. And that'll be 50% of spring. Another Lexus ISF. Cool. Well, let's do this in. So it's a dirt one. So we go in the RS200. Ford RS200, there it is. And it's put me backwards, okay. If I gain a little bit of run up. Let's go. That wasn't quite it. One more mile an hour. I have to do 81, is it, don't I? 82. Okay, we'll try that again. 82 is what they want. That was massively overslid. Bad corner. That was a bad corner as well. You have to spend as little time as you can actually braking and going. Bad also. What I'm gonna try is just do this. Oh, okay, that fails you. Okay. This is something I'm gonna try here. If I go down this hill, you just have such a ridiculous entry speed. There you go. Well, that failed. Why is this so hard? I also feel like that went from 130 down to 80 very far. So let's try this again. That was just bad. If I nail that jump, boy, he just doesn't turn. That's better. That seems to have worked. . 83.92, that seems to work. Just by completely jumping that first corner. I'm a speed zone hero. There we go. And the last one is this jump here. I think the RS200 should be pretty good at this. Oh. That's the jump. You get about 220. Let's try this. Well, oh, for fuck's sake. Really? About 50 more, isn't it? Yeah. What if I go down the full way? Oh my god. Didn't even register. Two, two, two. Oh, fuck off. Three more. I reckon if I straighten myself up and not lose speed on the jump. Yeah, I think I slipped there, so. Five is what they're after. Why can I only oh my god. Rewinding is just weird. Let's take it from about the top of the hill. It's dipping forwards. Oh, that done it. Bit of a bonnet slide, but we did it. My global influence is up to rank 53. So, go to message center. I've got businesses, shitloads of auctions. Gift car? I've been gifted a Koenigsegg CCX. Okay, let's take these super wheels then. Ford, not a lot. Let's sell the Fiesta. We have got a 5k, 20k, 5k. Why are these so rubbish? $15,500 and a Chevy Nova. Why are these so bad? Trans Am 2510. Just why? Can I not get a decent roll? 25 4 coupe, 400,000. That's what I'm after. Can I not break a mil in like six rolls? Six super rolls. No. $15,000. Hemi Cuda, which is 80, that's decent. Clio RS, which is 14. $2,000. 131, 19,000. And a Lotus Carlton, which is 30. All rubbish rolls. All of them just horrible. Right, let's get this. So what have they got? A Rothschild. A Mini. John Cooper works Countryman all four. I do not own that car. Any retro supercar? Let's see what they class as a retro supercar. Anything like this? Okay, then we're going to CLK GTR. Have a taste of luxury, speed and style as you race three a retro car and win three road racing series events. Okay, let's find. Let's go here. Knock three of these out. And go. Oh, an Enzo would have been good. But I think the CLK GTR is one of the best. Just because this is supposed to be a Le Mans racer. Well, this was made so that Mercedes could enter Le Mans. I mean, the F1 GT, yeah, that's the only thing that really compares. Oh, don't cut me up like that. Just stop me from turning. Really? I'm being outrun by Testa Rossa. How are these all struggling for top speed? I wouldn't have thought this would be struggling so much. Wow, I didn't think that would be that hard in a CLK GTR. Oh, we got two more of that. I say the only thing that should match me is this F1 GTR. All these other cars shouldn't. You'd have no chance. I think this car is better suited out for sprints and not small little circuits like this. And one more of this, God.
Mic off. Mic on.
Some of the all out aggression. Let's go. Come on. Take that 360. How is it so far ahead? Oh, for fuck's sake. A little bit aggressive on that. How is he massively catching up like that? Anyway, that's three. Engineering at the Headington, use retro to earn 3 stars at the Roman Mile Speed Trap. Where the fuck's that?
Where? Charging battery.
Where is this? Oh no, it's the Roman Mile. So what, we come from like here? I don't know what speed it's asking for, but this should hit whatever it is. You need 225. Maybe I should try the McLaren. Actually, before we do that, what does it say this can hit? 198? God damn, yeah. Where's the McLaren? Well, this was 240 stock, so what should this one be able to hit? $224. Really? And they're asking for $225? Oh, hang on. Ferrari. Where is it? Enzo. I believe this can do it. $222. But I believe this is untuned. Yeah, 874. So this will do it. Tune this Enzo up. Jumped us to an extra almost 220 horsepower. So now they should easily be able to smash it. Now I can do 244. It should be easy now. Wait, what? go to this player, make my way down. I feel like he might be starting the same thing. That's not the right one. I was on the wrong stretch of road. Might as well try this again. God, we're gonna take a bigger run up. I didn't think it'd be this hard. So entering the main straight at 200. That's just gonna send us off. /219 still. What am I doing wrong? I feel like I know what I'm doing. Okay, fuck it. That's what'll fix it. So I just make it the most ultimate Enzo. I've gained an extra 30 horsepower, dropped loads of kilos. Quickly go into designs and paints, paint the car. This to better colour. Oh, let's try this again then. We are now entering at 210. That's 225 already. 225.4. That was just good enough. Relish out magnificent rescue car. Drive it for 15 miles. I know what we can do on this. We just do one round of the Goliath. So I'm going to use the McLaren for this. An MT12 would be good. Fucking Jaguar. I actually don't know how this is doing so poorly. It's meant to be one of the best cars in the game. Why is that McLaren not being thrown around everywhere? And I have better aero as well. I360. I feel like Porsches are doing really well. That just did nothing. is this struggling? I feel like Team 10 have messed with something here. Cars feel a lot worse. There we go. That's all done. That was apple of my eye. And we've done 15 miles. Perfect. Poor. That'll be our 80% for spring. A Rover SD1. $7,004. Well, anyway, that's going to conclude this. I'll do the online when online's working and not broken. But anyway, we'll see you next week with more Forza and with the Season 30 update. Bye.